It's Friday, time for another weekly update. As we all know, COVID-19 cases, hospitalizations, and deaths are rising across the entire country, and sadly, also right here in Knox County. Look, we are all frustrated and fatigued, but we have no choice but to keep going. And with the vaccine on the horizon, there is light at the end of the tunnel, but we still have a ways to go. So please continue following good public health guidance. Utilize the 5 core actions, and this is very important, let's continue to support, love, and care for one another. On the Parks and Rec front, I have some good news and some bad news. The bad news first. Earlier this week, someone stole all the wiring at the Gibbs Park and East Knox County Park ball fields. It will cost upwards of $50,000 to replace the wiring and some of the poles that were damaged. If you have any information about these incidents, please contact the Sheriff's Office or Parks and Rec. Now on to the good news. Our crews will be wrapping up work on a new parking lot at House Mountain, adding another 15 parking spots to its capacity. At 2,100 feet, House Mountain is the highest point in Knox County. You can follow the 5.8 miles of twisting trails to its crest and see lots of wildlife on the journey. With the holidays here, I'd like to wish my Jewish friends a happy Hanukkah. Hanukkah, also known as the Festival of Lights, commemorates the rededication of the Second Temple in Jerusalem during the first century BC. It began yesterday evening and ends the evening of Friday, December 18th. Next Tuesday, December 15th, marks an important milestone in our nation's history. It's Bill of Rights Day, an observance recognized by President Franklin Delano Roosevelt in 1941 to honor the 150th anniversary of the ratification of the Bill of Rights. The Bill of Rights, of course, consists of the first 10 amendments to the United States Constitution. Now, ratification of the Constitution was hotly contested by the Anti-Federalists, a group composed of people like Patrick Henry, James Winthrop, and George Mason, who opposed the Constitution on the grounds that it granted too much power to the federal government. Adding a Bill of Rights was a compromise to help alleviate these concerns. James Madison was the chief author of the Bill of Rights. His goal was not only to protect the rights of Americans, but also to impress the importance of these rights onto the national psyche. While the Bill of Rights enumerates certain liberties, such as freedom of speech, a free press, religious freedom, and the right to keep and bear arms, among many others, it's important to note that the Ninth Amendment reminds us that these are not all the liberties that we are endowed with. And the Tenth Amendment forms the basis for our system of federalism by stating that rights not delegated to the federal government are retained by the states or the people. Along with the Magna Carta and the Declaration of Independence, the Bill of Rights is one of history's most important and influential documents, helping define the proper relationship between a government and its people. So happy Bill of Rights Day. Until next Friday, I hope everyone has a great week.